Dr. Janette Nesheiwat, who has met with some of these very lawmakers on the Hill on health care and what she'd like to see. Doctor, obviously the president has changed his mind from yesterday and is hell-bent right now on making sure Republicans are hell-bent on not leaving town until they get an Obamacare alternative out. What did you make of that?
Well, you know what? To me, that just shows how committed our president and our vice president is to improving health care for Americans, for my patients. I can't tell you how often I hear my patients complaining about how high their deductibles are. They're struggling. They're struggling to pay their deductibles that are so high. They're struggling to pay their high premiums and their co-pays. They can barely afford to pick up their medications. I can't tell you how often I'm printing out coupons off the internet for my patients to go pick up their prescriptions or on the phone with the pharmacist trying to get discounts for medications for my patients who can't afford it. And these are life-changing medicines. Medicines like an albuterol inhaler for someone that suffers from asthma and needs that in case they're short of breath or they're wheezing. But I can tell you, you know, the financial hardship and the strain and the burden on my patients is imminent to the point where patients are delaying seeking medical care. And usually the outcome is worse. Last weekend, I had a patient with a little bit of chest pain. She thought it was heartburn. She thought it would go away. She delayed seeking medical care. By the time she got in to see her doctor, who set her up for a cardiac stress test, she ended up not going because she couldn't afford the high deductible, and she ended up in the emergency room. And it cost 10 times more to go through the hospital and the emergency room than having outpatient testing.
But I'm going to go and do the stress test, find a way to do it. But, doctor, the one thing I did want to get from you is that it was portrayed that whatever trouble people were having with the Affordable Care Act, to your point that, for one thing, it's not affordable, it had been portrayed that what Republicans were coming up with was worse, that fewer people would have coverage for protections. The president is trying to rejigger that, and essentially was reminding Republicans, we're not marketing our plan that well. Is he right about that? Is it poorly marketed?
To a certain degree. Look, Neil, all I want to do is take great care of my patients, and I want to do that efficiently and thoroughly. We have the most innovative, the most amazing health care, and the most amazing medicine in the world. And we want to, as a doctor, myself and my colleagues, we want to be able to take great care of our patients. And it's unfortunate that we have these administrative and financial and prohibitive constraints that we can't do all that we can for our patients. Not only are patients delaying seeking medical care, but they're non-compliant with their medical care. They lost their doctors. The quality of care, unfortunately, is diminishing and is going down because doctors are burnout and there's a shortage of doctors. And to make matters worse, less and less doctors are taking Medicare.
Wow, that is amazing. Doctor, thank you for your good work, because I think you work with Republicans and Democrats alike. They're all human beings, so much appreciate on that.
Absolutely,
front.
And I believe in miracles and hope, and I think something, you know, will happen for the good of all, hopefully.
Very good. Good to hear that.
Good to see you again, Neil.
Doctor, same here.